Creating digital art using a blender is completely easy way, and maybe it seems difficult for beginners, but let me show you how to create this stunning image, atmospheric light in one click, and everything just in one blender. I have this simple scene, a final render I've got in a blender, including some post-productions and post-effects using compositing. So sit back and let's take a closer look how it works. The first on the way to stunning art is the camera, or rather the composition. As we see in my final scene, I have three cameras for different angles and resolutions. For this I use a photographer add-on, but this is not necessary. If you don't want to buy extra add-ons for the blender, everything can be done using the standard settings. We will definitely need compositing guides, which can be found in the camera settings, to make a good composition of the frame, because nice digital art is also a good composition. I use thirds to subdivide my camera view into thirds, also center and diagonals. The crossing of these guidelines is the key point of the good composition. Also, the direction of these guidelines gives the compositional direction of the frame that we can use. As you can see, in my case, the whole composition is built on the diagonals guidelines, and this also emphasizes the main direction of the plot of this art. So I'll also run the steps in this direction to the very central object of the plot, which is located in accordance with the vertical guidelines and the intersection with the diagonal guideline. All this creates a balance of the composition of the frame, and this is the basic of any art. No matter how we try to create a realistic picture or super realistic light, without a good and correct composition, all this will be in vain. If I look at my final art, the composition is not only the arrangement of the object in accordance with the camera guidelines. By adding light, I emphasize this composition, that I have the main object of the scene to which all these guidelines lead. I also highlighted some points along the way of the main object with light to let the viewer sketch on this point. How to make such atmospheric light? I'm going to use my Easy Light assets for Blender to do this. There are many ready-to-use light presets that can be easily adapted and customized. My main light is a beam that pulls my main object out of the darkness, for which I'll take this procedural light and position it outside the camera if the light is breaking through the ceiling somewhere behind the camera. I'll make it bright. If I open the shader editor, we see a knot of adjustment the light. I already talked about how texture light in Blender works, a link to this video in the description, but briefly let's open this knot. I will press tab, and here we see that the basic of the texture through which the light passing is the usual Voronoi texture, which gives such an effect of light. The input group node has settings for scale and seed, which can also be animated if necessary. If I decrease or increase the scale value, I will get a different light patterns. In the main render we also see this pattern, but it doesn't look so interesting, because we don't see the rays. To do this, I already have a volume cube with settings ready to use for volume light. Added to this scene. Now we can see atmospheric light rays. Scale this cube so that we can see the rays on the entire frame. Now we can adjust the scale to get more variety of the rays, for example, some kind of this. Next, these rays are quite sharp, which is not realistic enough. To get rid of this, I will open the settings of this spotlight, and there is a size value that allows you to increase the radius of the light source itself. As we see, the larger value, the softer of the shadow will be. I'll stay with 0.64, maybe this one. There are rays, but still pretty dark. In my main scene, there is quite a lot of light here, because I used another light source here. I will add it into the scene, it will work as a filling light of the scene. Just need to correct this color difference between these two light sources. I'm just going to copy the color from this light into this one, and it already looks similar in one color tone. If it's necessary, you may increase the power or radius, it depends on the situation. I also have many other sets of the light here. Most of these are procedural light, which means they can be easily adapted and customized if it's necessary. I posted a short video of how to do this on my Patreon, as well as all these assets. If you need, you can subscribe, download and use them in your project, or you may purchase it too in my shop if you would like prefer this way. Back to my scene. There are also lights that highlight this path and the stairs. Simple spotlight with not much power and significantly radius makes the light more diffuse, which makes shadows more softer. I also add area light here so that it's not dark enough, just as we did for the main light. This will emphasize the direction of the plot, giving a hint, slightly touching the rays so that the viewer can look at this path, examine these almost destroyed stairs and reach the main plot object. This is how beautiful art is created. It's not just a set of the object and models chaotically arranged somewhere across the scene. It's a set of patterns that consist of composition, the arrangement of the object in accordance with the composition, light and light spots that emphasize the necessary details. That gives a hint to the viewer where I need to look and what to examine in your art. Next, why the blender is so amazing tool for creativity, look at this material. They look quite realistic, but there are no stone textures. Because the blender provides powerful capabilities for creating procedural materials, and this one is procedural blender materials. I select this column for instance and open this material in Shader Editor to show you what this looks like. This combination of different blender texture and everything begins with Voronoi texture, but the result of this knot looks like this. It doesn't look like a stone, but by adding noise texture before, I can impact on this Voronoi texture knot, and this is closer to some kind of stone. Then, using the color ramp knot, I add the basic color of the stone to get this effect. Already looks interesting. In the next step, I add another Voronoi texture and also the noise texture, this time for small details. With color ramp, it turns into cracks on the stone. I combine my basic texture with mix knot and going to use this one as a mask. With this combination, I get the small cracks with color closer to the basic stone color. This is how we can use blender texture, combine them and make different settings and adjustments to get the necessary result. Here I have the mask grave texture, which again with help the mix knot add green areas like an outdated stone already slightly covered with moss. Next I add ambient occlusion and again merge using the mix knot, which will add such eclipse at the crack and geometry intersections. And then everything is already connected to the principles based there. Of course all this texture also need to be added as a normal to get bump on the stone. This is how it looks without bump and this is how with bump. Everything is simple, the main Voronoi texture through the color ramp connected to the knot of the bump to the high input, then this knot connected to the new knot of the bump, but already to normal and connected this texture to the height input, which is responsible for small cracks. So I mixed two different textures and converted them into normal map, which is exactly what the bump knot is responsible for. And that's what procedural material looks like. No texture except those blender. The same applies to the rock. It's also procedural material, except of the material of the soil with stones. This is what the procedural material of the rock itself look like. With the beginning of Voronoi texture, then color ramp, the next Voronoi, mix knot that used Voronoi as a mask for mixing colors, ambient occlusion, and everything is combined into one material. That gives a realistic result even without the use of texture of the rock. In general, in these scenes there are only a couple of textures that it took from the library. This is for displacement of the rock, tile is a broken tile pattern, and this material. Everything else is created exclusively by capabilities of Blender, which generally shows the Blender is pretty enough to create stunning image. I don't know if you need a detailed tutorial on how to create a procedural environment material. If so, write in the comment below. As you can see, the whole scene is pretty simple. There is also a waterfall for background water, which is also done procedurally. Noise and mass gravitation, which are quite strongly scaled on y-axis, give us such an effect of falling water captured on a long exposure. It remains only to add this a bump, alpha, and the waterfall procedural material is ready. So, this is render I've got, and let me show you how to make this boring image into stunning art using compositing in a blender. Turn off all the settings and let's see closer to each of them. The first note is color balance. Here I slightly raised the brightness in the white point of the picture and made small color gradient in the same parts. Then brightness, contrast and RGB curves. I did a little contrast, adding more depth to the picture. I don't know if it's noticeable because YouTube usually compresses picture quality. If so, this scene with compositing setup you may find on my Patreon. Then I work with mask. Blender allows you to work with mask in the same way as a camera roll, Lightroom, or DaVinci Resolve if we're talking about animation, and use this mask to impact on the image locally. For example, here the color balance knot is used to make a picture lighter, but I don't want to do this over the whole frame. I want to add it only here. For that I have a mask. See the difference? To add a mask in a blender, we need to choose mask in the menu instead of view in the image editor, where I already have opened my render. And we see the mask here, which helps me to highlight the part of the picture. I also make darker in the corner of the image, another mask and not hue saturation. Here I add a vignette with another mask. How to create a mask in a blender? In mask mode, press new mask, name it, and now you can draw the mask by pressing Ctrl or by pressing the add menu to select standard mask like circle and square. This will add a new mask. Press G to move and S to scale this mask as necessary. You can also make feather just by pressing Alt S. In order to use this mask in compositing, we need a mask node where I can select the mask that I need by name. Using mask, I emphasize the details and add a dark where it was necessary to add depth in my picture. The last three notes are post effects. Here I raise the exposure and added glare and lens distortion. The last one adds a bit of chromatic aberration and distortion by simulating a camera lens that creates such blurred distortion at the edges of the frame as the real cinematic camera, and finally makes the picture more cinematic. Of course, you can say that you can do all this in Photoshop and it even works faster, but this approach allows me to see immediately the result with post-processing in the process of working using real-time compositor in a blender, which appeared in Blender 3.5, and this is a very powerful tool for working. This makes it possible to do everything until the final in the blender without jumping to Photoshop, and in order to see how the final result can look. Also, you need to understand that compositing is not a tool for final picture, even in large production. After the compositing stage, there is a process of color grading in DaVinci Resolve, but you can easily use compositing to complete the render to the results that compositing in a blender allows, and then makes some more adjustment in camera roll, Lightroom or DaVinci Resolve if you work with animation. So the blender gives you pretty cool opportunity to do stunning art inside one program. As you have seen, I made this art without even using some textures, mega scans or purchased 3D models. The only models here are plants from the plant library, which can be found for free on Blender Market. For scattering, I use G-Scatter, which is also free, and all this gives unlimited opportunities to create such picture using Blender only.